Hi friends, welcome to our channel. We are doing a series of 10 class mathematics. As a part of this, we are now in the chapter probability. In probability, we have already discussed many concepts. We are doing now problems on those concepts. So today also let us solve 2 to 3 problems, some simple but important problems. Later let us discuss the experiments like tossing 2 coins simultaneously, rolling 2 dice simultaneously, like that. Okay, let us get into the class without any late. Okay, now so see here, let us start directly with a problem. A game of chance consists of spinning an arrow which comes to rest pointing at one of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so see here. So this is the spinning wheel, you think now. Okay, this is divided into 8 parts. Okay, each has equally likely outcomes, Nana. Here, you see here. So let us take the numbers like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and there is a pointer. There is a pointer. Okay. So we need to see that it is a game of chance. Okay. And these are equally likely outcomes. What is the probability that it will stop at or it will point at? The first one is probability of pointer stopping at 8. The next one is probability of an odd number the third one is probability of a number greater than 2 and third and fourth one is probability of a number less than 9 You need to find all these probabilities, Nana. Okay, so see here, what are our total outcomes here? Total outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right now, all the outcomes. So all the possible outcomes are 8. Okay, so what is the probability that it stops at 8? That means the favorable outcome is only 8. The number of favorable outcomes are 1. What is 1? What is that 1? That is nothing but 8. So here the probability will be only one favorable outcome out of total 8 outcomes. So 1 by 8 will be the probability. See here, the next one, probability of an odd number. Okay, what is the probability of an odd number? Means see here, how many odd numbers we have? That is 1, 3, 5, 7. So these are all odd numbers. Okay now. So see here, this is an odd number, this is an odd number, this is an odd number, this is also an odd number. So how many odd numbers we have there? We have 4 odd numbers out of 8 outcomes. So here the probability will be directly 1 by 2. And probability of a number greater than 2. Now. So here, what are the outcomes? 1 to 8 are the outcomes. Greater than 2 means CNN. 3 is favorable, 4 is favorable, 5 is favorable, 6 is favorable, 7 is favorable, and also 8. Total how many outcomes we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total outcomes are 6, favorable outcomes are 6 and total outcomes are 8. So what will be the answer now? 3 by 4. What is the probability of getting a number less than 9? Now you tell me the answer. Less than 9 means what are the favorable outcomes? All the 8 are favorable. So 8 favorable outcomes by 8 total outcomes. Here the probability value is 1. What do we call the probability of an event is equals to 1? What kind of an event is that? That is nothing but certain event or sure event. I hope this concept is clear for you. Then let us go for card problems. Already we have done some problems and these are the problems from your exercise. So just I want to explain those also. Why? Because some students are even feeling difficult in remembering the cards. So see here now, how to find out this probability. One card is selected from a well shuffled deck of cards. How many cards will be there? Total of 52. The probability, find the probability of getting. See here, we have 6 questions here. The first one is the king of red color. The first one is king of red color. Next one, a face card. Third one is a red face card. A red face card. Fourth one is a jack of hearts. Jack of hearts. Fifth one is a spade card. And sixth one is queen of. Sixth one is queen of diamonds. Okay, now so let us see here. Already I have given you a complete view of all the cards. What are the symbols we have? How many red color cards will be there? How many black color cards will be there? Okay, if you don't watch those video, that video, please do watch that one. Then only you will understand this problem clearly. Okay, now so king of red color. Red color means diamond will be in red color. Heart shape cards also will be in red color. In both diamond shape you will be having one king, and in heart shape also you will be having one king. So total how many, Nana? Two red kings will be there out of 52 cards. What will be the answer now? 1/26. Okay, next, a face card. I have already told you JQK are face cards. JQK are face cards. So in each and every symbol you will be having 3 face cards. We have 4 symbols, total of 4 symbols. So 4 threes are 12 face cards you will be having out of 52 cards. This is nothing but how much, Nana? 12/52. You cancel it. 4 threes are 4, 13 are. So answer is 3/13. Next, red face card. Red face card. A face card means you will be having 12, I told you. Red means diamond and heart shape only, no? In diamond you will be having JQK, and in heart shape also you will be having JQK. These are the face cards. Total 6 face cards we have out of 52. Out of 52, none. Okay. So if you cancel this, you will be getting 3/26. Next, jack of hearts. In all the heart shape card, you will be having only one jack. So that is 1/52. Directly answer. A spade. You will be having a total of 13 spade cards. You will be having a total of 13 spade cards out of 52 cards. So the answer is here 1/4. And next one, queen of diamond. This is same as jack of hearts. Queen of diamond. In diamond you will be having only one queen. So answer is 1/52. 1/52 now. So in this way you can solve the problem related to cards. You have one more thing also. So see here, that is without replacement. That is a special case. Already we have done when we are speaking about some lot or box kind of problems. If you don't watch those, you do watch it. I'll tell you the problem. Okay, we are doing the problems from the second exercise now. Okay, see here, there are 5 cards it seems. The 10, jack, queen, king and ace of diamonds. What, Nana? 10, jack, queen, king and ace, all are of diamond shape only. All are of diamond shape, Nana. All are of diamond shape. That means all are red color cards only. Okay, now see here, what is the probability? Only these 5 cards are there, not 52, complete deck. Only these 5 cards are there. What is the probability that the card is queen? What is the probability that the card is queen? So what is the probability of queen here? We have only one card out of 5. Simply the answer is 1/5. Here you see here, if the queen is selected and put aside. If the queen is selected and put aside. That means now we don't have queen here. Okay. What is the probability that second card selected is an ace? Is first question here. That is, the second card should be ace after putting queen outside. Okay, so ace means you have only one. Now you have only total of four cards. So what is the probability of an ace? Here, that is 1 by 4. And the second one in the second case is probability of getting a queen. Probability of getting a queen. Already we have taken queen and put aside. Now we don't have queen in the total cards. So what is the probability of queen here? There are no favorable outcomes for queen. So that is 0 by 4, which is equals to 0. What do we call an event whose probability is 0? That is nothing but impossible event or uncertain event. See here, after taking out the queen, is it possible for us to get a queen again? No, it is impossible. That's why the probability is 0. I hope you have understood this concept. If you have any doubts, you do comment in the comment section. And in the last case also, I have asked one question. What is that? What is the probability of getting a red king? I think so. What is the probability of getting a red king? Comment in the comment section. Okay? Comment in the comment section. I'll see. Next. Next, we will be going to some other problems, like the problem related to region. The problem is now related to region, which is important. Okay? This problem has come for you in 4 marks section. This is very, very important for 4 marks. So focus here. Simple. Region means always the formula is same. Always you need to find out what is the favorable thing for us and what is the total. Whatever the problem might be, you should do the same concept here. You should apply the same concept. For example, see here, Nana, what is he telling me? He has a board. He has a rectangular board. Okay, and there is a circle in the middle. The dimensions of the rectangular board are 2 meters and 3 meters. And this diameter of the circle is 1 meter he has given. Diameter of the circle is 1 meter he has given. So this is the board. Okay, by placing the board here, he is just dropping a dice now. He is just dropping a dice on the board. What is the probability that the dice will land inside the circle? What is the probability that the die land inside the circle? So what is our favorable area now? Favorable area is the circle. What is the total area? Can you find it? That is nothing but the total rectangle area is our total area. Simple enough. What is the formula actually? Probability of an event is number of favorable outcomes, by number of total outcomes, right? This is the formula actually. But when the problem is related to region, you simply write favorable region by total region. You think like that, that's all, that is enough. Here you cannot find number, no? So favorable region by total region will be your answer. So see here, Nana, when we are find our favorable region is the circle. So when you drop a dice, it should fall in the circle only. That means what you need to find here, this is very, very important. That is nothing but you should find area of circle. What is our total region? Total region is nothing but rectangle. You should also find the rectangle area. Okay, Nana. So see here. So favorable region is circle. What is the formula for the area of circle here? That is pi r square. But here diameter is given. The diameter is given. So how can you write it? So see here, Nana. The diameter is equals to 1 meter. So what will be r? R will be simply 1 by 2 meter. Why? Because radius is equals to half of the diameter. So 1 by 2 will be your radius. And total region is a rectangle. Write the area of rectangle. What is the area of rectangle? That is length into breadth. Here length is equals to 3 meters and breadth is equals to 2 meters. Okay, now length is equals to 3 meters and breadth is equals to 2 meters. Now you apply the formula. Okay, So what is pi nana? That is nothing but 22/7. Can I write it directly? And r square. R square is nothing but 1/2. R into 1/2 by L into B. By L into B. That is nothing but 3/2 nana. That is nothing but 3/2. Now after simplification, see here 2 1s are 2, 11s are, this will be 11/7, 2s are 14, and also you have some denominator, that is 6 here, 3 2s are 6. So what is our answer now? That is nothing but 11/84. 11/84 is our answer. What is the probability that hits in that dice will land inside the circle nana? That is nothing but 11/84. I hope you have understood this concept. For suppose if the question is like this, what is the probability that a dice landing outside the circle, dice landing outside the circle, then our favorable area will be this shaded part, right nana? Our favorable area will be the shaded part. First of all, you need to find the favorable area. Then the formula will be changed simply. So that is L into B minus pi r square you should do. Why? Because favorable area is total rectangle other than circle. So you should remove circle, right? You should remove circle. So in this way, you have to change the favorable region. I hope you have understood this concept. Okay. If you have any doubts, you do comment in the comment section. I'll try to clarify. Okay, Nana. So these are the concepts. Okay, if you want, I can solve this for you. So let's change the problem here. What is the problem now? When a dice is dropped, it should land on the rectangle area other than circle area, other than circle. That means outside the circle it should land. That means C and L into B, that is 6. Already we have done 6 minus 22/7 into 1/2 into 1/2 nana. 1/2 into 1/2 by 6. L into B is again 6. So simply you simplify here, that is 11. 7 2s are how much nana? 14. 7 2s are 14. You just multiply here by taking LCM. 14 into 6. How much it is? 14 6 are 84 minus you have 11 by 7 2s are 14, and down you have again 6 in the denominator, again you have 6 nana. Okay, so simplify this one. 84 minus 11 is how much? That is simply 73 by 6 into 14. The answer is 73 by 84. The answer is 73 by 84. See here, this problem also can be done by using complementary. The first case is find out the probability for the die landing in the circle area and subtract from 1. Already we have done for the probability of circle area or not. What is the answer you got there? 11/84. Now what is my question now? It should land outside the circle. It should land outside the circle. That means it should not land in the circle. So see here, probability of circle area is 11/84. It should land outside the circle means it should not be in the circle, right? It should not be in the circle. This can be written as 1 minus probability of in the circle. So which is equals to 1 minus 11/84. This is 84 minus 11/84. The answer is again 73/84. So the problem can be of any model. The problem can be of any type. See here, for example, there is a square. You can see that it is a square, and there is a triangle like this. There is a triangle like this. What is the probability that it hits in the triangle area? You should find it triangle area, and you should take it as a favorable. And what will be the total? Complete square area will be the total area. So in that manner, you have to convert the problem, and then you need to do it. Okay, I hope you have understood this class. If you have any doubts, you do comment in the comment section. And if you like the class, don't forget to like it. And if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe and hit bell icon in order to get the notification for the coming videos. And share to your friends if you think the classes are very, very useful. Thank you for now. Let us meet in our next class by taking the dual experiments like rolling 2 dice, tossing 2 coins. Bye for now.
for me.